Namaste students. Now, in the last session business studies class, you have seen which are the various sources of external, which are the various methods under external, internal sources, and also you have seen what are the merits and demerits of internal sources. So now we'll see what are the various methods under external sources, and we'll see also along with that merits and demerits of external sources. If you see internal sources, there only two methods were there, that is transfer and promotion. Internal sources is nothing but just we select our own employees from one department to other department. We will shift sometimes, that we call it as transfer, and sometimes we will promote them to the higher position. So that is in case of internal sources, and we have variety of advantages if we go for internal sources. And also along with that, we have variety of disadvantages if we go for external, internal sources. Now let us understand what is external sources. External sources are nothing but we are going outside the organization in search of candidates. We are going outside the organization in search of candidates. That sources or method we call it as external sources. Then what are the different external sources comes under that? So there are altogether 10 external sources according to your syllabus in the textbook. So we will go through one by one. Here first comes direct recruitment. What is a direct recruitment? It is in case of factory workers where they require unskilled and semi-skilled workers. Where they require unskilled and semi-skilled workers in case of factory. If some of the employees, if some of the regular employees, if they are absent for some days, if they are absent for some days, or sometimes they require some employees, they require some employees. So what they will do? They will write on the notice board of the factory, outside the factory, or sometimes they may write near the entrance or the gate. They may notice that they may write a notice like we require some of the employees or the workers are required. We call them workers for who we give the daily wages. These are the daily wages workers and who are semi-skilled and unskilled. Those who are where we require semi-skilled and unskilled for a particular plant or factory. They will write in a notice board that employees are required. And they will come and assemble in the particular factory, and in a spot only they are getting selected. For particular, the absence of particular employees, they will place these employees. Or sometimes, not the absence of some other regular employees, sometimes they actually require the employees for a long run. So they recruit in that particular method. That is, we call it as direct recruitment in case of factory worker, where they require semi-skilled and unskilled workers. Only in such case direct recruitment is possible. Otherwise, they have to undergo variety of procedures in order to recruit the employees. That is the first one, direct recruitment. Now, second one, what is this casual scholar? Now, most of the candidates, not the candidates, after completing their particular qualification, he completed some of the graduation or post-graduation. What he does? He will, for some reputed companies, there will not be call for from any of the companies. But on his own interest, these qualified people, they apply for some of the reputed companies. When they apply for some of the reputed companies, they just receive the application, but they will not verify the application, or they will not solicit those applications. These are called unsolicited application. Unsolicited application means which are not screened by the organization. They receive the application, they just keep it. They will not look into the application, because at present there will not be any kind of call for, or there will not be any kind of vacancies. What this organization will do? In the future, some necessity they may arise for some of the candidates. That time they will open and see that application, which are unsolicited application, they will see. If they find suitable candidates in that out of that application, they call for them for the interviews. They call for them for the selection process. That we call it as casual callers. It is nothing but the qualified people, after completing their qualification, on their own interest, they apply for some of the reputed companies. even though there will not be no call for from any of these companies. And these companies just receive the application, they will not go to screen the application or they will not go to check the application since there is no vacancy or not necessary. But in future, when they find the necessity of candidates, they will screen that application and they will, if they find suitable one, they will call for the interviews, that is casual ones. The next one, advertisement. Advertisement is nothing but, as I said, we give advertisement in different different media. It might be the print media, like newspaper, we advertise. How we advertise, we give the job description. Which kind of jobs, how many jobs are available, what kind of qualification they require, what kind of the skill and knowledge they require, and how many years of experience they require. So all the descriptions we give in case of advertisement, that we call it as advertisement. That is the third source. Next, fourth one, that is employment exchange. What is employment exchange? It is an organization run by government. The people, those who complete that qualification, they have to, if they want, they have to go to the employment exchange. They have to register. They have to register in the sense, they have to provide their resume or job details they have to provide. What is their qualification? Which kind of job they are seeking? They have to provide it with the employment exchange by registering and by paying some of the fees there. What these employment exchanges will do? These will act as the intermediate between the job seekers and the job provider. Who are the job provider? Job providers are different companies, and job seekers are these candidates, those who will go to employment exchange and those who will register over there. And these employment exchange, they will receive the application from the candidates and they will register. And if they find any of the suitable jobs for these candidates, they will get notice from the different kind of companies also. If they find suitable one, they send notice to the, they will intimate to the candidates. Like this kind of the job which you were seeking, such kind of jobs available in these kind of companies. Please go and meet. Such kind of things they will inform. So these are the employment exchange. But most of the time, this employment exchange, many people will go and register, but very rarely they will respond and they will send. Sometimes for which they will respond, they will send notice. Such kind of jobs, sometimes the person might not be interested also. But this kind of sources are there. This kind of sources are there. It may not work efficiently. And next one, placement agencies. See, there is no much difference between placement agencies. Placement agencies are also some of the kind of employment exchange. But placement agencies run by the private institution. So what it will work better than this employment exchanges. These will be having contact with a variety of companies, and here also the job seekers or the candidate has to go to that employment agencies, and in that agency they have to register. By providing their detail, they have to register, and there also they have to pay certain amount of fees for the registration. Once after getting registered in that particular organization, and if they are having contact with the variety of companies, if they find such kind of job, what they do, they provide notification to the suitable candidate. So these are similar in nature, but it will work more efficiently, effectively than employment exchange, because it is run by government and it is run by private institutions. The next comes the sixth one, campus recruitment. And this is one of the, which one you all are aware of this particular source. Here what happens? The various companies go, they go to the various kinds of college campus they will go. And they will conduct the recruitment process, that is selection process, various kinds of tests they will conduct. This will take in majority of all kind of professional colleges, the engineering colleges and all, majority of the professional colleges, this campus recruitment will be there. Then next one, seventh one, recommendation of employees. What is this recommendation of employees? Now, for example, one employee is working in one particular organization. What he does, if there is any kind of vacancy for one particular job, he will suggest for his higher authority the one person whom he knows very well, whom he knows very well. He will recommend one person whom he knows very well to the higher authority to recruit him as a one of the candidate. That we call it as recommendation of employees. This used to happen in the older days. This used to happen. For example, someone's uncle is working with a reputed company. What he is done? What he does? He joined later. He will join all his relatives in that company. So due to his recommendation, other some of his relatives also they will go and they will join in that particular organization. That we call it as recommendation of employees. One existing employees, he will recommend some other employees, some other new employees to whom he knows very well. It may be whom he knows very well or some other his friends, relatives or anyone, he will recommend to the higher authority to take him as one of the candidates. The next one, that is labor contract. Where it happens, this labor contract, and this is in case of construction companies and all, where they require the huge number of workers, where they require huge number of workers. What happens, there will be some particular persons, they will be called as contractor of laborers. They will be having the group of laborers with them. They will manage those group of laborers. Those who have come from some other states or some other places, they will come. One group of laborers he will be having. And this, the construction companies and all, they will contact who? These contractor, the labor contractor, they will contact and they will ask there are particular, the completion of particular project. They require those group of employees. So this contractor, what he will do? He will send those workers to that particular project. The agreement he will send and he will get commission over there. So he will send that particular, the group of employees to work in that particular project for some particular period of time. After if that project gets over, then this labor contract, these laborers will come back to this contractor only. Then he will send them to some other workplace where their laborers are necessary. So this is mainly in case of construction companies where they require workers in the huge numbers. There will be a people called labor contractor. They will send employees to some particular project for some particular period of time. This is also one of the source. Then we have seen advertisement. Then two more are there. Advertisement on television, advertisement of web publication. Advertisement on television, what? That is nothing but we provide advertisement in the TV. That we call it as advertisement in television. Other sources that we have print media. Print media is not so expensive compared to television, but television has a wide broadcast. It will reach to the large number of people. If we give advertisement on television, what happens? There will be huge publicity for that particular advertisement, and there will be a speed publicity, huge publicity, huge number of people can see it, and there will be a speed publicity also will be there. If we give advertisement on television, it is also one of the source of external source. Then web publishing. Web publishing means, as I said here, through internet we publish, we give information about the job. These kinds of jobs are available. From that companies can search. For example, mainly as I said, that is Naukri.com. You have heard about Naukri.com or Jobstreet.com. What happens here? Candidates will be variety of candidates. The number of candidates with their detailed information, they will be provided their information in the Jobstreet or Naukri.com. So from there, various kinds of organization can find the suitable candidates which is required for their organization. So these are the different sources. Then altogether 10 sources are there. Direct recruitment in case of factory workers where semi-skilled and unskilled workers are required. Casual callers are for reputed companies where the applicants on their own interest they will send, and when it is necessary they will call for the interview. Advertisement, the next employment exchange, which is the organization run by the government who will be having the contact with the job seekers and the job provider. And placement agency, which is run by some of the private institutions. Campus recruitment, they go for the campus and they conduct the interviews. And recommendation of other existing employees to take up new employee. Then labor contractor, the contractor who provides the huge number of labor for particular kind of project for particular period of time. Advertisement on television and web publishing. These are the various sources. So next we will move towards what kind of merits and benefits these sources can give. Now we'll see what are the merits and demerits these external sources has. Now, first one, if we see the merits there, qualified personnel. What is that qualified personnel? See, in case of external sources, if we go for external sources, as I said, we can choose people, means which kind of qualification we require in our organization, what kind of skill and what kind of knowledge this candidate should require in our organization, we can find them. We can find them. Yes, this person has that required qualification and also skill and knowledge which my organization is required. So such kind of person which is actually required, similar kind of persons we can get in case of external sources. We can, as I said, we can get for which kind of people we are seeking, which kind of people or which kind of candidate we are seeking, same kind of candidate we can get. That is one of the benefit for the benefit if we go for external sources. And next one, wider choice. How we can get qualified personnel? Because then we have wide number of choice. In case of internal sources, there is only choice, where there is only limited number of choice. We have to find employees or we have to find for one particular post or one particular department where there is a shortage of employees. We have to find within our organization only. We have their limited scope. We don't have variety. But here in case of external sources, we have variety of sources here. So we have wide number of choice. We have plenty number of candidates in front of us. So we can choose the best one. We can choose best one out of variety of candidates. When we have number of candidates, we can select the best one. Which kind of the qualified person we can choose if we have variety of choice. And then next one, that is fresh talent. As I said, we can get new blood into the organization. If we get fresh talent, what happens? They'll be having new kind of skill. They'll be knowing the technology, advanced technology they will be knowing. And their thinking process, their thought process will be completely different. So we can get new blood into the organization. That is also one of the merits of external sources. In internal sources, what happens? There is no scope for fresh talent. There is only the existing employees only. We have to use it as, and we know what kind of talent they have, what kind of skill they have. We cannot get or we cannot expect more from them. But if we go for external sources, we can get fresh talent. Fresh kind of technology they will be knowing and the new kind of skill and knowledge they will be having. They will be very updated. We can get updated candidates for our organization. Then the last one in case of merit, that is competitive spirit. What is that competitive spirit? How we can build competitive spirit? What happens for the existing organization? Now they know this our organization getting some fresh talent into the organization. They are going to get some of the fresh talent or the new candidates who are coming from outside. What happens with the existing employees? Existing employees now they will be prepared to compete with the new talent, or else they will think if we are failed to compete means then our importance will be reduced in this particular organization. So they will be more alert, their alertness will be more. Existing employees alertness will be more. However, these are the fresh people, their energy or spirit will be more. So there will be competitive spirit in the organization will go up. If an organization goes to the external sources, it will competitive spirit among the existing employees also. Due to they have to prove their existence in that particular organization. So these four are the merits of external sources. That is, one is qualified person. They can get that desired qualification. They can get that desired qualification in a candidates, and by their choice they will be having plenty of choices in front of them. And fresh talent, they can get new talent or new blood into the organization, and competitive spirit of the existing employees can be increased due to the incoming of the new people. Then, if we go to the demerits, what are the demerits of these external sources? Now, when we did the first one, dissatisfaction among the existing staff. What happens when new people are entered into the organization? As I said, one positive thing is competitive spirit will increase. The negative thing is there will be a dissatisfaction. Existing employees are not satisfied. They will be thinking, yes, we have in this particular organization and we are working since from past 15 years or 10 years. Then after this also, why our organization or superiors are going to get candidates from the other places or from outside? There will be dissatisfaction among the existing employees. So what they may do, their efficiency may go down. They may not be having any motivational factor to increase their efficiency. They may not work efficiently. So if they may not work efficiently, what happens? That is directly related to the productivity and profitability of that particular organization. So this is also one of the important factors. They may think or there may be a dissatisfaction among the workers. We cannot say that there will be a dissatisfaction. With some people, there may be a dissatisfaction. Some people may take it in the positive way. They can increase their competitive spirit in order to compete with the new people. We are not lesser than them. So, with some people, it may go in the negative way. It will be there initially. The positive, some people take some things in a positive way. And same thing, some people may take it in a negative way. Then, next one, lengthy process. Yes, this I have told in case of work. Internal sources, it is a very, very lengthy process. Very, very lengthy process in the sense. It starts from the manpower planning. They have to plan how many number of people, what kind of people, what kind of qualification, what kind of skill. They have to plan. This planning takes some time. Then after planning, they have to go for recruitment. In recruitment also, they have to give which kind of recruitment we should go, whether television recruitment or whether it is print media, or we have to publish it in any other books or magazines. They have to think. After that, they have to search there. Then they receive the application. Out of variety of application, they have to screen the application. They have to evaluate the application. Then some application they have to select and they have to call them for a interview. After calling them for interview, they have to conduct one by one selection test and face-to-face interviews and all they have to conduct. After that, they will select some people. Then training should be provided. After that, we have to conduct orientation program. Then they will come to for the actual work place to work. So it is a very, very lengthy process. It takes so much of time. So it is one of the main drawback of external sources. That is a lengthy process. Then if it is a lengthy process, if these many stages are there in case of staffing or in case of if we go for external sources, obviously it is a costly process. Compared to internal sources, it is very, very costly process. In each and every stages or in each and every steps of the staffing process, we have to spend them. We have to spend them. So it is a costly process. But with this we can conclude the external sources. But if we observe internal and external sources, then it is better to go with the, even though it is a costly process or lengthy process, it is better to go with the external sources. I'm not saying internal sources, but none of the companies or organizations will not go entirely for external sources and entirely for internal sources. It depends. For some position, if they require one candidate for higher authority, it is better to go. Sometimes it is better to go with internal. We know the people very well. They know the environment very well. It is better. Sometimes it is better to go for outside. The main reason there shouldn't be any kind of dissatisfaction and many variety of advantages we get. We get qualified person, wider choice, fresh talent. So these are the very important benefits we should have. Always the fresh talent should come inside the organization, then any kind of changes can happen, or they will be prepared for, you know, to meet various kind of challenges situation. So it depends upon that organization's strength or their nature. They have to select for which source they have to go. So entirely they cannot go for external also, entirely they cannot go for internal also. There should be a balance. For which kind of position it is better to go for external, they have to go for external. For which kind of position it is better to go for internal, they have to go for internal. So this is about recruitment. In case of recruitment, two sources, that is internal sources and external sources. In case of internal sources, transfer and promotion. And what are the benefits? We take our existing employees and internal sources means. There are two sources, transfer and promotion. Externals are, these 10 sources are there, their merits and demerits. Here, with this, we can wind up the topic of recruitment. And next session comes there, it's about placement. It's about selection. Next session, there we'll see what are the procedures of selection. So, we'll wind up.